All right, we're back. I'll still give it another minute or so. Cuz Yeah, I got the gloves on, by the way, finally, guys. In case you're curious, glove update, we're good. Should refresh your guys' streams as well. Weird internet bump, because of the increasing heat in Las Vegas. Poor shame, man. I got all dressed up for the event. Got these damn gloves on. The internet can't work. Alright, are we back up? Are we good? Are we solid? Okay. I'll give you all another couple seconds to get caught up. Take over to our randomizer screen. Let me know if you guys are good. Alright, so I'll just read off the names. Then give you guys some time to get caught up. We got Alex, Daniel, Dexter, Dion, Suleiman twice, Dion again, Suleiman a third time. We got James G, Neil W, Woody B, Kelvin P, Woody B again, and Jeffrey rounding it out. So we have our order. Probably should have just waited to read it till then, but no. There's our order. In a slightly lighter red. Hey, what's up, Xyphon? Okay, gotcha. And so here we go. So first, the first card is going to go to Woody B. Card number two is going to go to Dion. We're straight down the list, so you guys know. Jeffrey, you're getting 3 and 4. Dexter, you're getting 5. Alex, you got 6. Suleiman, you have 7. Daniel C, you have 8. Woody B, you also have 9. Dion S, you got 10. Kelvin P, you're going to get card number 11. Suleiman, you're going to also get cards number 12 and 14. James G, you got 13, and Neil W, you have 15. Morgan is killing, man. We swap out here on the breaks, so we actually just missed Mr. Drooper. Well, here we go. I'm trembling right now. I'm absolutely quaking. I was joking. I'm dead. So we have the Legend Booster Pack right here. This server marks, it's on the team back on the outside, don't worry. We will also be randomizing the pack away, the pack itself. I know some people like to collect the, you know, the wrapper. We'll probably have some time, Xyphon, at the end of the night for some personal breaks on stream 2 for sure. So if you want some, just whisper us and we'll see if we can't fit it in. She probably won't return for Thousand Night Drooper. Her voice is pretty shot. We've been very busy today, so. Alright, here we go. One pack of boosters. So, you guys don't know how this works. Imagine everyone involved does, but in case you're watching and you don't, I'm going to open up the pack, take all the cards out. I won't reveal them. I'll sleeve them all up, shuffle them, and then we'll go through it one by one in the order that I just read out. So here we go. Let's... Yeah, okay. Facing me. Okay, gotcha. So I'll flip it over. So I'm not looking at
the
this.
The cards are facing me.
Okay, so if I pull them like this, it'll be the back of the card.
It'll be the back of the card.
Okay. Cool, there we go. These cards are literally older than I am. By 2 years, and that's just not natural. We're gonna sleeve them all up. And then the rules card will be randomized off. And we will just run down our list and reveal the cards. And I will judge my reaction based off of if Ivan goes, oh, or not. There we go. There we go. I'm gonna take my time with this too, so if I'm quiet for a few moments, you guys will realize I'm actually really made sure I don't, you know, ding anything up in here. Well, it's going pretty smooth as well. Oof, man. It's hard with gloves on. I don't like this with gloves on. So, DD Ben, maybe tell me, what's in here? Like, what's, you know, obviously it's hype because it's vintage stuff, but, like, what's in here? What's like, the good cards? Abernathal? He'll tell me rarity? Cool. Luckily, I got the, MTG Tutor in the chat today. Mana drain, okay. And of course we have our rule card. This, I'm gonna save this one up too. And this will be randomized off along with the actual housing of the pack. Which by the way, for reference, I know a lot of you guys know this, but 1994, I was born in 96. That's still, that's nuts to me. That's so weird. Really? God, that's so crazy. That's so weird. Here we go. So we are going to shuffle them up a little bit. So I'll just, what should I do? I don't want to do like a pile of shuffle. That seems like messy. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, I didn't see anything, I swear. Okay, we're good. Do it like that. Very gentle. Very gentle like. That, yeah. And here, Ivan, do you want to cut for me? Here, Ivan's gonna cut in the mold.
And I think take off your.
Awesome, alright. Cool. Breathe. Cool, alright, there we go. Alright. Jazz hands, everybody, let's get hype. Alright, so Woody B, card number one will be yours. Here we go. Got the top loader right here. We got Jovial Evil. There we go. Jovial Evil. Rare.
But
it's actually Morgan. She's still here, but she's like off to my right side. Alright, here we go. Dion S. Keepers of the Faith. Your white card. 2-3. What's odd is, even though this set came out before I did. Oof, my god. I actually recognize these mana symbols. Like, I don't know, it's nostalgic for me still, because, a lot of what I played with growing up was my dad's cards. Jeffrey, by the way, these Nets 2 are gonna be for you. Vampire Bats, and Zephyr Falcon. So, like, a lot of the cards he played with was from this era. There you go, 3 and 4. The Zephyr Falcon and the Vampire Bats. Some flying friends for you. Then this next one is made for Dexter B. Got the Brute. Man's got no neck. Yeah, that's not flesh and blood. All out from MTG all the way back in the 90s. Here we go. You have subs, LD Gaming Studio. You cannot because we're mostly on Twitch. Here we go. Alex. Got to Immolation. Just in time, Roxy. We're about halfway through it. Suleiman, here's your first card. Another Vampire Bats. Daniel, here we go. Anti-Mage Aura. Yeah. For 8. Great for Daniel, yeah. I'm gonna, yeah, let me top load this one real quick. And then make sure I don't lose track. There we go. Anti-Mage Aura. I'm gonna do this too. This is purely off-camera stuff, but it's gonna help me stay organized. All right, here you go, Woody B. Card number 9 is going to be Keepers of the Faith again. Card number 10 is gonna go to Dion. Another Zephyr Falcon. Oh yeah, yeah. That's still coming up, Roxen. Don't worry. Yeah, not done that one yet. Zephyr Falcon. Number 11 for Kelvin. Ooh. Hammerheim. Cool looking card. That's why I said ooh. Holy. Boom. Oh, that's a cool card. I like it. Alright, Suleiman, here's another one for you. Card number 12. Sir Chandler of Eberine. The legendary creature that literally does something. Still cool, man. Still cool. Yeah, that's card number 12. There we go. Sir Chandler of Eberron. 13 going to James G. James Gunn. Eternal Warrior. Ivan, if you need a link for that, we can get that for you. Exclamation point, Facebook, and chat. Ado Suleiman. Card number 14. Superchink Kobolds. Spelling. I think so. There we go. And we have our final card for Neil W. Fire Sprites on the final one. There we go. So I'll go back over again, and then we'll do the pack itself, and then the rules card. There we go. All right, so we had the Jovial Evil as the first card. Keeper of the Faith as card number 2. Vampire Bats as card number 3. Zephyr Falcon as number 4. Oop. Got the Brute as card number 5. Put down there. Immolation as card number 6. Vampire Bats as 7. Anti-Mage Aura 8. Keepers of the Faith 9. Another Zephyr Falcon for 10. In order. At the Hammerheim artifact or legendary land at 11. Sir Chandler of Eberron 12. Eternal Warrior at 13. Superchink Kobold at 14. And then Fire Sprites at 15. There you guys have it. And then of course we have the just gonna make sure these are in order. And then we have our pack. You know, the wrapper, and then we have the rule card, which we will randomize off in just a moment here. I mean, are you ready on that? Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Cool. I said we do the rule card first. Right here. Let's jump into it. Yeah, well, I think no one in chat responded, so I think we'll just do the rule card first. We have the pack itself as well. On top of the rule card as well. There's one. That's two. Three. There's three. Four. Five. Six and seven. To Woody B. My Sharpie's done. But Woody B, this is your rule card. Congratulations. A very classic rule card. Make sure that gets a into your area, and now we have the pack wrap. There it is, check it out. Tried my best not to completely destroy. I think I did a pretty good job. Here we go. One, that's two, three, there's four, five, six, and there's seven. Suleiman, throw your vintage material, man. Here you go. You get the Legends pack. That's just actually insane. I really didn't know what to expect going into it, but it's a really cool opportunity to be able to open up a sealed pack of, like, cards that are older than I am. You know, they were born... This was, you know, made when my brother was born. Like, you know, so it's just... It's so insane to me to think that, you know, now I get to open up cards that are... have been around for longer than me. That's just cool. I don't know. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Don't go anywhere though, because we still have Time Star Remastered coming up. We had that from our Facebook group appeal. If you guys didn't know, got a Facebook group now. Be sure to join it. At some point, Facebook and chat will bring up the link for it. And actually, you know what? Let me fix this camera too. There we go. You saw a little bit of the background scene. Be sure to join our Facebook group. We have exclusive deals there, and this is where the Time Star Remastered deal comes from. So we'll be back in a few just for that. Thank you again for this opportunity to open up Vintage Magic. This was really, really cool. I love learning about Magic's history and all that. So we'll be back with you guys in just a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. What's up, you guys? We're back. We're doing a set that came out well after I was born. We're gonna be sorting a little bit of Strixhaven while we wait for our TSR to be ready. We still have a few slots left, so again, if you guys would like to get in on that, how many did you say? I mean, it was four.
Four left.
Got four slots left. Want to get in on some Time Trial Remastered? It's part of our big group break. Should I head over to our Facebook group? We have our daily deal there for that. Exclamation point Facebook. Yeah. Lucky Gaming, you keep asking me that, but I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to do with it. You gotta work for subs, man. There we go. We're just gonna be oh my god. Here, let me switch the pack. You guys can't see what's going on here. Got some ooh. Bit of tape on the stream deck too. Let me get that on. There we go. We got some Strixhaven here. This was break number 477. What's up, this is your break. Tell me how you feel about your pulls. If not, and maybe you missed it, well, you got a little bit of a chance to see what we got. It's such a fun set, man. I think just, you know, all the, like, JP Altarts look really, really cool. I can't really decide on, like, which one I would want the most, besides, like, a, you know, maybe, like, a small handful of them. You know, it makes me almost want to just, like, buy a box of them, and whichever ones I get, I get. It's the same way with JP War of the Spark. All the alt-arts just look so cool, I can't really decide which one I want. I'm retired, yeah. That sounds like a good point to do so, DD Boone. You definitely chose a good stepping off point, it would seem. Love that source of Plashers artwork too. Although from what I've researched on a bit and just from watching different Magic creators and how they talk about it, it seems like Shirtan is a bit of a of an underpowered set compared to what's come out before it. I also hear that Throne of Eldraine is incredibly broken. Man, you might know a little bit more than I do on that. So if you got any info on that, I would love to hear it. Strixhaven is such a cool set. Hope they continue doing sets within this plane. There's a lot you can do with it. It's way too broken. Was it like a mechanic they introduced, or was it a specific card? That's case too. I love Throne of Eldraine. I love the theming of it. That's. Bone Crusher Giant and Lushtrad Beast. We've got a couple copies of Bone Crusher Giant, so. That's the one that you can cast it at an instant, not the creature, but the effect. You can cast at instant speed and prevent all blocking to be done. That's just, yeah, okay. I definitely see that being a problem, but too bad. Ooh, Dina Soulseeker is one of my favorite cards in this set. Really, really cool artwork. With all the snarls as well. Bayren is a cool commander too. Very fun. I like it when they embrace the multicolor stuff. The houses and all that. I thought that was cool. Very reminiscent of the guilds. Just a fun new way of doing it. It's in Veil, Body of Research. Venture in general, Embercleave. I have Embercleave too. Great Henge. That's really good. Ankle Robber of the Rich. Well, let me ask you this, man. How do you feel about the cards that you showed off in AFR? Personal opinions on the origins of the set aside, how do you feel about the cards that are revealed within it so far? I think a lot of them sound really fun. Very much looking forward to the set dropping. I think we get it soon. Who knows what it is. Into your hands, terrible. If ours is underpowered. Is that compared to a different set, or is it just overall? Take away from the set. Yeah, that's definitely gonna be a big one. Just I think also the fact that there's five of them, one for each mono color. Watch them to so many different decks that way. And you have a couple of the multicolored ones, but then just a lot of them being monocolored definitely helps. Because I don't just have to resort to one, I can multiple in there depending on my colors. Same core. I love the adventure modules. I know a lot of people don't like them, but I love them. Oh, it's live on Magic. Oh, okay, Magic Arena. I know they're still showing off the commander cards, which is by default what I'm looking forward to. Just because at the moment I only play commander, but it looks like fun. I don't know. I'm very excited for it. I think it'll be very cool. Probably, I'm gonna try and pick up one of the pre-cons if I can. Just want to have another deck, but also get some of the new cards in it. Here's the one that comes with Treasure Vault. Yeah, Demolix 5. What does that one do? There's a lot of them, so I have a couple in my mind still, but I'm still trying to remember most of them. Probably there. Oh yeah, that's true too. They're kind of setting themselves up for Nets rotation. Have a bit more of a baseline to build off of than just trying to power creep even more. Ooh, I love this Dark Ritual too. Like my favorite artwork. And, okay. Hey, there it is. So you cast this turn. This is the next stream. We'll be back on Tuesday. It's our Friday here at the Warehouse Trooper. That does seem really, really good, though. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right, that's right. It's the four water, or four blue. That does seem very good. This one, no much of those. I don't plan on playing standard, so for me it's purely a, you know, how would this card be in Commander, and that's where I watch a lot of my videos too, is by people that play Commander. Watch a lot of game nights and all that. Watch a lot of Tulane Community College too. I mean, like, there's some, so I have, you know, a bit of an idea, like, about what's good in standard, but I really don't know why. There's a lot to learn though. I'm very excited. Keep you know, diving in on this. How are we looking on our Facebook page, Ivan? Quick update for y'all. Two slots left if you want to get in on some TSR. Oop, head on over to our Facebook group. That's my point, Facebook in chat. And I'll bring you to that. And we got an exclusive deal right now. Get you a pack of TSR for 15 bucks. Normally got them for 30, so a nice little half off deal right there. And stick around too, because we got daily deals going up on there. Oh wait, I think this is the one I did. Yeah, this one I did the other day. The Counterspell and Natural Order ones. Yeah, Cody too. That card is so gross. Ryan built his initial EDH list with Cody as the commander, and that card is not very fun to play against. Got like two or three turns and that's it. But yeah, Xanathar too. Xanathar looks absolutely nuts. Yeah, I think that's what they wanted with that. Upkeep, choose target opponent. Yeah, that's just absolutely insane. That's definitely gonna be like, I'm also kind of excited for it too, because, you know, when that hits the battlefield, it's gonna be like kind of like that D&D moment where everyone's like, oh crap, this thing just showed up, now we gotta deal with this. What do you have to deal with it? Do you have any spells that can deal with it? You know, I think that's gonna create a lot of table politics. And that to me seems like the most fun, you know, way to play commanders. Really being interactive with the group around you instead of just grinding out your own thing. White weenie. Oh yeah, didn't Monitor gain a few things too? A couple new things to help out spirits. You know what, I should probably do this. Isn't that very parasitic? Hope they expand on the dungeon mechanic. If it's just like a one and done thing, that'll be kind of lame. But I don't see that being the case though. Just by the way that, like, the set is branded, it's Dungeons and Dragons, Adventures in Forgotten Realms, which makes me think they would do more Realms of D&D as sets in the future. That's what makes it sound like to me. Yeah, that's true too, but dice rolls are a little weird. The second you introduce RNG into anything, I mean, it's not gonna be good. Like, look at Pokemon with the prize cards, you know. It can be tough. Talk about, like, it's like a hope that he's like, yeah, you know. Yeah, you know. Playing with dice rolls is pretty tough. Random number generators suck. Jesus. Yeah. think Ivan actually wants to play Mills, so as soon as he, it's gonna be something he has to look at. Oh, I didn't even grab tokens today. Then we got black. Mill is gross in Magic. Mill in Pokemon is so, like, innocent by comparison, dude. Mill in Pokemon is, like, discard the top two cards of your deck. You know, one to two cards. And Magic is, like, mill 14 cards. Mill 15 cards. Mill 8 cards. Like, jeez. It's just so brutal. It's nasty. Oops. Blue? Oops. There we go. Alright. Ravenloft, yeah, that'd be cool too. Everwinter. I can try and redeem Dark Alliance from that video game they just made by doing a D&D set of a 2. Feels like there's a real dead. I mean, you know, more tools are just more tools overall. I can see them continuing on with the D&D stuff, though. You know, it's Wizards of the Coast that runs both of them, so it's gonna be no surprise. Oof. That, now you're seeing my language, Corey. That would be awesome. That's my kind of set. Maybe that seemed like, maybe, though. Like, I can see it going another way. See it being like a, you know, like one done, that's it. Yeah, that's true too. Unless it's like a specific for a format, maybe there's another supplemental product that dips over standard, kind of like we do with MH2. Even that, I think maybe like, you know, what, once every 2 years, I think that set averages, right? Yeah, every two years? How long does the set last? Rotation once a year, so. Just add lessons. Okay, yeah, that's true too. Leave stuff from outside the game. There we go. There you go, guys. We just sorted up. Rats, you sorted in order. Here we go. Brick 7 break number 447 is done. Or 477 is done. Boom. Go. Play with Evan tomorrow. Night, Corey. Good luck on your thing, man. I really hope you get what you're going for with the whole, like, expanding your play group and all that. Really hope that works out for you, man. Sounds like a great initiative. And if it doesn't go exactly the way you want to tomorrow, keep working at it. Don't give up on that. But guys, Ivan, you still back there? Ivan there? Oh, I see. I was gonna ask if we got an update on the TSR, how that's going. Cool, there we go. I haven't went to the bathroom, so I really have no way of checking. Right now, anyway, myself, I have no way of checking how that's going, so we'll just chill for another minute. Again, guys, if you want to check out our Facebook page, we really appreciate the support there, and you get some daily deals too, so win-win. It's another way that we get to hang out with you. Join our Discord too. Well, it's kind of blood. There's still two left. All right, thank you, Suli, for that update. Y'all get in on it? Hey, there's Ivan.
What's up?
That was just a nice one. It seems like we're still sending out two slots left for our TSR, so y'all hop in on it, man. Still two, gotcha. Ooh. Static-y. Ooh, look at that nice wooden texture, right? You know, if that playmat looks. There we go. Boom. Well, what's up, y'all? Let's chat. What's happening? We're just chatting channel now. I grabbed another order, but everything else is so big right now. And it's, what, 8:30, almost 8:40, so Y'all want, I mean, if it doesn't launch tonight, we'll do it on Tuesday. We'll fire it on Tuesday. So, I imagine two slots will go over the weekend. And obviously we'll have a new deal on Monday, so we'll kind of like double up there. But if it doesn't fire up tonight, we might have some time for personal breaks. Yeah. Yeah, so if you guys want to get in on that, so are we just going to wait until Tuesday then? Okay, so sounds like T-Star is going to wait until Tuesday, so if you guys don't want, if you don't like that idea, that's totally fine, just send us an email and all that, we'll jazz up with that. But T-Star sounds like it's going to be put to Tuesday, so if you want, we got time for some personal breaks. A couple here. If it ends up firing off tonight, I'll stay late and I'll open up the patch with you guys. But watch some personal breaks. We can totally do that now. Give y'all some time to decide that. CFBBoxBreaks.com for those personal breaks. We'll be back in just a few minutes, guys. I'm going to go run to that for myself. I'll be on just a couple of seconds. Don't go anywhere. What's up, you guys? We got some more sorting going on, so let's just chill for the rest of the night, pretty chill Saturday night. Actually, what I'm gonna do here is next level tech. No one could ever expect this. There it is. What's up, John? Boom, zoom out on it. Now you guys have to see the entire thing. That's pretty good. There we go. Cool, so now you guys have to see the, entire landscape. We open up some, as we sort some cards. You just chill for this at night. Solid box. This is, there it is. This is our Chilling Rain 2 booster box break. Had Riley and David in it. So if you guys are hanging out in chat, here's your break, man. Looks like solid for my. By the looks of it. The only rates that I still gotta get. Still gotta get into. Oh, there's so many good cards in it, so like I really don't know what I want just yet. I have a bad tendency of especially in Pokemon. Of buying a bunch of cards, building lots of decks, and then they kinda just become irrelevant like immediately because Pokemon has a weird issue of printing really good cards. Then immediately printing cards that counter those really good cards, and it feels bad, man. There's so many types too. Here we go. One for fighting. So, you know, it's tough being a Pokemon player, man. You get excited for a deck, you know, you put some time into it, really, and then Pokemon puts a counter to it the very next set sometimes, and you're just like, you play spaghetti, try your local Italian eatery, Stormhawk. That would be my go-to, I suppose. Maybe make it yourself. There's a couple of DIY videos you should probably watch on how to cook some food. Italian's really good. It's hard. Fire it there. It's some oven mitts for you to make your spaghetti with, man. Yeah, it's just... Oh. The energy symbol on. It's really dark. I meet you, GS, and a regular Mewtwo. Nice. Yeah, it's pretty cool. Very good, Mewtwo. There's Mewtwo and Mew GX. That was really good. Tag team card was super busted. Still is. I mean, it still sees tons of play today. Even after it rotates, I think it'll still see tons of play. Melanie. Melanie's a super good card, too. But these sets look great, but I'm so hesitant to, you know, build anything out of it. It's like, I have a feeling it's just going to rotate soon. Or not rotate. Just have a card that just counters it immediately printed. So I'm gonna hold out. I'm probably gonna build Rayquaza VMAX for sure though. It's, I mean, it's gonna be at the Emrakul. Yeah. Yeah, there you go. I'm probably gonna build Rayquaza VMAX for sure, just cause it's gonna be a dragon type. Dragon types are back. It has no weakness, like where it says like weakness down here. Oh, that's a bad card to show. Weakness down here. There is none on dragon cards. You know what? Yeah, standard's kind of in a weird spot right now too. So I don't think you're really missing out on much. Because I haven't played standard in a 3 months now, I think. Ooh, nice. Yeah, that's still a solid hit, man. Nice job. The standard's a little bit weird right now. There's a lot of decks right now. So it's kind of hard to figure out like what, kind of like what to expect if you're gonna go into something, because you got like both Calyrexes are doing good for some reason, Zacian fell off, ADP's kind of fallen off a little bit, Urshifu is still doing good, Single Strike has a lot of hype now, the Inteleon decks have been going off, Mewtwo and Mew is still running around. Pikarom, straight up Pikarom is still alive. Somehow. Eternatus had the comeback of the century. It's like one of those popular decks now. Nothing made sense anymore. So weird. It's just strange. Rowlet Exeggutor is like a top deck still too, with Mewtwo. I'm not sure if it's the Boombox variant. I think it is. It's with Boombox. It's Mew3 with Boombox. Yeah, and have it rotate in a month. Oh, well, yeah, there you go, man. These are all just energy. Yeah, it's Rayquaza, man. Ray Eels is back. You know, Ray, Ivan's popping off. Like... No, Rayquaza looks out. Have you seen the alt art? Yeah. Oh my god, dude. The Noivern alt art is It looks really good. On top of that, like, the card is just going to be so... So, in no weakness. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I love how they're like, let's take away dragon types for a bit, and let's see if we can't balance them. And then they said, we can't balance them, put it back. Yeah, no, that's gonna be... And I think the Rayquaza has, like, 330 HP. And you can't one-shot that at no matter what, unless you're playing single-strike Urshifu V-Mats. It's either at 320 or 330. I don't think anything can one-shot that. Yeah, I have the... I mean, he might. God, dude, like... That's a lot. That's a lot of HP. And then he can one-shot you pretty easily. The boss is gonna be so broken again. I'm all for it. But no, it's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be fun. I think after this year's rotation, when tag teams are finally gone, I think that's gonna be a really fun time to play some Pokemon. Then at that point, I'm not gonna be too worried about like a fun archetype popping up because of rotating cards. I can just build stuff with Sword and Shield on, and it'll last a while. And I definitely want to keep running with Urshifu, because that list is so, so cool. Although there is an Ice Rider Calyrex that runs Cincino, so I might play that one as well. Whichever list lets me play my Cincinos, I'm gonna play it. Big F in the chat. Well, it's a good thing we're chilling sorting then. Don't know what we do. Trying to do TSR with... What time is it? Like 20 minutes left. Oh man. We're just kind of kicking off right now. Hopefully with things reopening, it means that we'll see our communities grow as well. I think Pokemon's especially going to be weird because you had a lot of people buying Pokemon cards that weren't going to play Pokemon. Some of them might start, but we'll have to wait and see. I think what's going to be... Yeah, it's over here, Zyphon. I think because sometimes it gets really hot in Las Vegas, we have like energy and internet issues. Especially in some of the older parts of town. Some of the newer developed parts don't really have the same issues. Better insulated, but some older buildings out here definitely have those issues. And I know this is an older building because that wall right there is straight up just cinder blocks, and it heats up because there's no insulation in it. So it's just something that happens out here. Back when I was younger, like in high school and all that, at my parents' house, where we lived, there's, you know, power lines running over it, so it wasn't completely underground. And every summer, one of those lines would burst just because of the heat. Something would have it like the box that rests on the actual power pole itself will just burst. We'd have to, you know, get that fixed and all that. Yeah, it's Ivan downloading something. It's Ivan downloading proxies to play Rayquaza VMAX. There are no steel types here, are there? A lot of fighting types for some reason. That's actually good, I said to download more RAM. Should I play your Minecraft server, Ivan? Needs a more dedicated RAM. Oof. That's a concept. The box breaks Minecraft server. I love this Lapras art. That, oh yeah. I can't close up. It's just a lot of lights. It's kind of hard to show off some cards sometimes. There we go. This Lapras card's really cool. It's got Melanie in the background. Someone's gonna take that seriously, Ivan, and they're gonna be really bummed out when there's not actually a CFB box breaks Minecraft server. Doesn't mean it won't happen. There we go. What else we got going on? Hopefully you guys were able to make out some of your F&Ms last night. Game stores opening back up. Don't need me to tell you, but, you know, go and support your local game stores whenever you can.